Hello, welcome in After Kids. We're out here in the beautiful Colorado wilderness doing some winter dispersed camping. I've got these brand new cots we just unboxed. We haven't slept on them yet. Don't know how they're gonna be. Can't even remember the actual name of them because I threw the box away. But I'll put the link in the description below. We'll talk about these cots as we put them up and talk about how comfortable they are. They look comfortable. They're not the high dollar Cabela's ones, you know, for the $250, but they're not the cheap ones either with the bar across the middle. I just refuse to do that. We're gonna see how these sleep. We're gonna see how easy to set up. Y'all hang with us. Should just snap right in place is what the directions say. Now they said those are for big boys. They don't look like it's gonna be for a big boy, does it? Well, it's not snapping in place like they said it would. Maybe we're not holding our mouth right. They said just push down. Snaps in place. Huh. Yeah, but is that it? I mean, it feels like it's snapping in place, but it's not catching. Well, and all those fails, let's turn it over.
It's these that need to snap into place. It's right here, right there. That one did.
This one did, no, it ain't.
There we go.
Huh. I guess that did it. We'll chalk it up as new. Yeah. All right. That wasn't as easy as the video, but it comes with this 3-inch pad is what they said it was. Well, I guess right there, if you don't push it down, it may be 3 inches. Well, gets us better than nothing. And then these go over the ends like that. Like that. What do you think? You're not looking at it too promising. All right, time for redemption. I got another one here. Let's see if it snaps into place as easy. Push down on those ends, maybe. Maybe, I don't know. You wanna put them this way or you wanna put them that way?
Whatever way this is not in the way, so.
Well, we should have got a 12 by 12 tent.
Okay.
We left all of our sleeping bags down in Texas, so we had to get some 20 and 10 degree sleeping bags for this weekend. Hopefully we use the crap out of them. We plan on doing this kind of setup for a while. Well, even though it took a little bit to learn how to set these up, I think it was just because it was new. We were having a hard time getting them locked in this place. I don't know. I guess the more we use them, the more we're going to know. But I can tell you right now, this little padding they have on top, that's just maybe one step above sleeping on the ground. But I think once you get your sleeping bag and everything on here, it's not that bad. It's pretty comfortable. So it seems like a pretty sturdy frame. I mean, it held my big butt up all night long. I just don't like this mat.
I thought they were comfortable.
She thinks they're comfortable, so that's really all that matters. But woke up this morning with my left hip hurting. I don't know if it's just because of old age or just because I'm not used to sleeping on this. They are a little bit hard, but it's not a $5,000 Serta mattress either. So I'll put the name of these across the bottom there where you can see them, because there's no markings on them. I'll tell me what the name is. I'm gonna have to go on Amazon and figure out who I bought them from. But for a cot that's under $100, but yet over 40, you know, because the cheap ones are just horrible, I'd say it's the best you're going to get for that money until you get up into that big dollar range. Other than that, so that's kind of my review on the cots. We're going to use them a lot more this spring when we do some more dispersed camping up in Dinosaur Monument in Utah and things like that. But all in all, you get what you pay for. I'd like to thank you for tuning in. And if you haven't already, if you got something from this video and you liked it, go ahead and hit subscribe button. I really appreciate it. Other than that, always remember, leave it better than you found it. So until then, I'll see you down the road.